What's up, guys? Welcome back to Eerie Covenant. I want to go over spirit guides with you today. There are many types of spirit guides: animals, angels, ancient gods, ancestor spirits, spirits, even incubi, and succubi. I am not with it today. My mind is scrambled. Anyway. Spirit guides can pop in and out of your life, kind of helping you along your path. Others have always been with you. So if you are very instinctive, you'll be able to feel them around you. If not, I suggest trying to pay attention to any little signs, just expand your mind and be more open to whatever your spirit guides may be telling you, but we'll get more into that. They may try to contact you in a few ways. I have 10 signs that your spirit guides are trying to get your attention. And at the end of this video, I'm going to let you know how you can try to contact yours. Sign number one. Messages in books, movies, songs, etc. that stand out and hit you emotionally. It can be a word, a phrase that impacts you for no reason. Pay attention and try to analyze why this impacted you. That can kind of set or direct you toward whatever you're feeling and help you along in your path. Number two, feathers. Mostly white is your spirit guides letting you know that they're there. Other colors can be from family or ancestors or another spirit. Sign number three, dreams. Vivid dreams that is intense, and you may see or speak to an animal or person in it. Make sure that you write these down, every detail. Dreams is one of the main ways that my spirit guides send me messages, so I try to pay extra attention to my dreams, but they have tried to contact me in other ways. Number four, meditation and visions. They may show you signs or symbols in this way. When you meditate and you just see random things, try not to think, try not to manifest anything in your head, just let it be, and you will start getting symbols or images in your head, and that could be from your spirit guides. So, number five, channel writing. Again, don't think, just start writing. Whatever comes and pops into your mind, it don't have to make sense, it don't have to really come together in a full-on sentence, it could just be words, but whatever pops into your head and you feel compelled to write. And that could be messages from your spirit guides. Number six, numbers. 1111. My fiance always sees 1916. 1212. Those are just examples. I also saw those numbers around the time that I met my fiance. He is my twin flame. So it could be your spirit guides just sending you something nice. Number seven, touch. Have you ever felt chills or like someone just touched you or pushed you and you're like, ooh, maybe it's in my head? Well, no, it's not. It may be your spirit guides or spirits that are trying to work with you. Number eight, orbs, shadows, and lights. Any colors. Seeing those can let you know that they are there. If you see a shadow at the corner of your eye, if you see lights or orbs, doesn't matter what color, they could be your spirit guides. Number nine, you suddenly, for no reason, put to mind that you need to look up things about spirit guides. Like you feel you need to find them, you need to find out about spirit guides, what they are, and you're researching it and you don't know why. Like nothing put it in your head, you're just doing it compulsively. That is another sign. Number 10. Things or circumstances change your life, but you feel like you are supposed to be in that place at that time. For example, when I met my twin flame, it kind of shook both of our lives. We were lost, but felt more found than we ever had before. And it was kind of like the universe merged us together. So I really feel like our spirit guides helped with that. It was a spur of the moment thing. It was crazy, but crazy awesome. When they know you are ascending or expanding your consciousness, then they will reach out to you. Most of the time, they leave these little crumb signs. Yeah, I said it. Mm-hmm. Yep. I've come too far. I'm not redoing this video. They leave these little breadcrumb signs, the ones we discussed in this video. So pay attention to those signs. And also, I've always seen mine in dreams, like I said before. They'd be vivid but encrypted, so I'd be left to kind of decode these hidden messages. I've had animals, I've had an incubus, I've had a few spirit guides. Also, your familiar, if you have a familiar thought form and spirit, or you're working with them, they will help you and be your spirit guides. There are so many different kinds. So I hope this helps you. There are also other ways to contact them through divination, meditation, tarot or oracle cards, and lucid dreaming. I recommend watching my lucid dreaming video. I'm doing a 3-part video to lucid dreaming, astral projecting, dream walking, and I'll be uploading part 2 tomorrow. And if you need help decoding any dreams that you feel are important or vivid and you really don't know what they mean, I can interpret them for you. And if you need help with that, email me. And as always, guys, love and light from Erie Covenant.